I welcome you all to this lesson. Today I'm going to discuss on the topic, I Know Why the Cage Bird Sings, which is composed by Maya Angelou. In this poem, I will discuss line-by-line explanation, word meaning, poetic devices, theme, and moral of the poem. So here I begin. First of all, I will discuss the title of the poem, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings. The title of the poem is referred to as Caged Bird. Caged bird is significant because the poem compares the life of the bird who lives freely and the one who is confined to a cage. Both birds are symbolic of the groups of the people they represent. It is a very famous poem which represents a symbol for all the Africans and Americans and fight for their freedom. Now I will tell you something about the poet Maya Angelou. Maya Angelou was born on 4th April 1928 and died on 28th May 2014. She was a contemporary poet and wrote quite a few poems, and all of them have been successful. She was a powerful feminist writer of Afro-American ethnicity. She was Afro-American means the dark American, not the white one. As a result of which, she had to experience a lot of racism, maltreatment. She had been treated badly on the basis of her race and gender. Her childhood had been traumatic when the parents separated and she went to live with her grandmother. And then, as the time passed, she had many traumas in her life, as a result of which she had lost her voice for 5 years. After that, she regained her voice. She was a fighter who fought against racism, freedom, against trying. So this is a poem against black authors' struggle. This is also a novel in this name, that is, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sing, is a 1969 biography describing the early years of American writer and the poet Angelou. It illustrates how strength of character and a love for the literature can help overcome racism and trauma. She was a poet, singer, civil rights activist who published 7 autobiographies, 3 books of essays, and several books of poetry. She is credited with a list of plays, movies, and television show. She also won many awards and medals. Now, a brief description about the poem, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, composed by Maya Angelou. This is an autobiographical poem. The poet has made her best effort to show the life of the free bird as compared to that of a caged bird. The poet has written this poem as a struggle of a black author. So, the bird in the cage is a symbol of all the Afro-Americans and their fight for freedom. It symbolizes the struggle of being a black author whose words are not heard and the one who longs for freedom. Here the poet compares herself to the caged bird and also refers to all those people who are suffering, that is, discrimination and being tortured, frightened, treated badly, and all other cruelties. The poet raises voice against this operation. Very nicely, she has juxtaposed the two images, the image of the free bird and the caged bird. Here the free bird is referred to the white people. They have everything to do for themselves and are free to do anything. Whereas the Afro-Americans have a lot of restrictions on them. So, she voices a protest against this trial. The poet brings to the limelight the plight of marginalized, mistreated Afro-Americans who suffers from racial discrimination, injustice, and Operations of the United States. Now let us start with the first stanza of the poem, and the lines are: a free bird leaps on the back of the wind and floats downstream till the current ends and dips his wings in the orange sun rays and dares to clean the sky. Now the word meaning. Bird refers to the warm-blooded egg-laying vertebrate with feathers and wings. Here compared to the white Americans, leap means to move. Wings refers to the power of the in the poem. Sun symbolizes freedom. Sky is the symbol of glory. Downstream means to the direction of the stream's current. Dip means immerse briefly into the liquid so as to wet, coat or saturate. Wings refers to the movable organ for flying or a means to flight or ascent. Orange sun rays refers to freely and lively atmosphere that the bird lives in. Orange rays also symbolizes happiness, freedom, comfort and luxuries of life. Dares refer to the challenge to do dangerous or foolhardy. Claim means to assert or affirm strongly. Now the explanation of the first stanza. In this stanza, the poet describes the world of nature to be beautiful and the beauty of the nature by stating that it is evening and the whole sky is orange in color with a beautiful sunset accompanying it, making the whole scene breathtaking. The poet refers to the plight of the bird, of the free bird who springs freely from the ground to the sky in the direction of the air current. It looks as if the bird had immersed his wings in the orange rays of the sun, covering the sky without any restrictions and enjoy the beautiful sunset. The free bird refers, flies as if the sky belonged to him. The free bird refers to the white Americans who were free to do anything and did not face any racial discrimination and could enjoy their freedom. Whereas the caged bird behaves abnormally, like the one who had a nightmare, because he is sad and miserable. For the state of captivity is abnormal, for as he is denied for the freedom of movement. The caged bird is referred to the Afro-Americans who suffered from the racial discrimination, injustice and operation in the United States. In this stanza, the poet symbolizes sun as freedom, the sky symbolizes glory and the wind symbolizes the power in the poem. Now the literary device used in this stanza are: number one, the rhyming scheme. There is no definite rhyming scheme that is followed in the poem. In this stanza, no definite rhyming scheme is followed. Number two, metaphor. Metaphor is a figure of speech in which a comparison between two different things is made directly, indirectly. In this poem, the caged bird is a metaphor for the poet herself. It represents the misery and distress of all those Afro-Americans who had to face inhuman treatment, discrimination and prejudices during the apartheid. In this stanza, the poet uses metaphor when she compares the wind to water. The word downstream and current makes us think of the tides in a sea or ocean, and the lines from the stanza is: and down floats and floats downstreams till the current ends. Number three, personification. Personification is a figure of speech in which abstract ideas are invested with personality, and both inanimate and abstract ideas are endowed with the attributes of living beings. The poet has personified the two birds when he says, clips his wings and dares to claim the sky. Number four, visual imagery. The poet has employed visual imagery to pictorially portray the situation. It refers to the words and phrases used to help to the readers imagine each of the senses, that is, smell, touch, sight, hear, and taste. It helps the readers to make the graphic pictures in the mind. The line from the stanza is, "The free bird flying in the orange sky and the caged one standing on the grave of dreams are substantial visual images." Number 5, kinesthetic imagery is a sense mediated by the receptor located in muscles, tendons and joints and stimulated by bodily movement and tensions. The words that describes this type of imagery are in this stanza are leaps, floats and dips. Number 6, hyperbole is identified as an extravagant exaggeration not to be taken literally but used figuratively to create emphasis, and the line from the stanza is, "and dares to claim the sky." Now I move towards the second stanza and the lines are, "But a bird that stalks down his narrow cage can seldom see through his bars of rage. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing." Now the word meaning. Stalk means to follow an animal or a person that you are hunting or trying to capture by moving slowly and quietly. Bars of rage are symbolic to the bird's confinement. It refers to the anger, to the bars of rage as it feels trapped and sees no way out of his situation. Clipped refers to the hold a sight of grip. In the poem, the bird longs for freedom but is restricted not only to the cage but also its wings are clipped. His wings are clipped means that his freedom is forcibly taken away. Opens his throat to sing means to say that it seems to be his only joy and achievement in life. Now the explanation of the second stanza. In this stanza, the poet begins with "but" because it represents contrast to the first stanza. The first stanza describes a happy free bird who was happy, joyful and satisfied. Whereas the second stanza describes an unhappy bird in captivity. That is dark, unnerving and even frustrating. The cage is now narrow because the cage bird's movement are restricted. The Afro-Americans were to stay in a restricted area. The bars and rage means that the cage bird is angry and his vision is restricted because of his anger. He is miserable and helpless. His feet are tied and his wings are clipped. So his movement in the narrow cage is restricted. Under such circumstances, the only option he has is to open his throat to sing. The poet tells us that the caged bird can seldom see through the bars of the rage. They rarely get a glimpse of the sky, while the free bird enjoys the full sky. She felt restricted from enjoying the freedom that should have been her right as a human being. Because of the above reasons, she started singing in her own way to express her longing for freedom, as it was the only way to express, because she was inside the cage with her feet and wings tied together. Now the literary device used in this stanza are, number 1, the rhyming scheme. In this stanza, no definite rhyming scheme is followed. Number 2, alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of the consonant sound at the beginning of the nearby words is used in places like "can seldom see through," where repetition of S sound is there. Number 3, kinesthetic imagery. The words in the stanza which describes this imagery are clipped and sing. Now I move towards the third stanza, and the lines are, the cage bird sings with a fearful trail of things unknown but longed for still, and his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the cage bird sings for freedom. Now the word meaning. Trill means to produce sound in an unsteady way, especially because you are afraid or nervous. Fearful means experiencing or showing fear. Hill means a local or well-defined elevation of land. Long means to have something distant, means separated in place of coming far away. Now the explanation of the third stanza. In this stanza, the poet says that the caged bird quivers while singing, and the things unknown. He realizes his condition, but still longs for freedom. The poet reveals that the bird's cry for freedom is heard at a faraway place. It was fearful because of all the uncertainties of life, whether he would be free someday, whether he will get the unknown things that he longs for, like a smooth and free bird ride on the back of the wings that the free bird enjoys. The line, things unknown, refers to the fact that the bird has never enjoyed freedom before, and so has no idea as to what it tastes like. Though he is singing for freedom that he has longed for all his life, it is something completely unknown to him. He is singing for freedom, something he does not have. The idea of freedom is in his dreams and what he cannot achieve. So he sings about it. There is fear in his voice. He had never known what freedom tastes like, but hopes to have it for his own. His voice can be heard in distant places, on hills where it inspires others to dream for freedom. The caged bird does not sing of sadness, but of hope, inspiration, and of freedom. Now, the literary device used in this stanza are, number one, the rhyming scheme. End rhyme is used in this stanza, that is, in the second, fourth, and sixth lines of this stanza, and the words are trill, still, and hill. Number two, auditory image. It creates deep and auditory effort to the readers. Auditory image is produced when the poet refers to the birds singing his fearful trills and his tune. Number three, personification. The poet has personified the two birds when he says, sings for freedom. Now I move towards the fourth stanza, and the lines are, the free bird thinks of another breeze, and the trade wind soft through the sighing trees, and the fat worms waiting on a dawn bright lawn, and he names the sky his own. Now the word meanings. Free bird refers to the Americans who are free to do whatever he pleases, and so he is happy and content. Free bird thinks of another breeze refers to the freedom which the free bird has. It can soar in the sky to various places wherever it wants to go to find its food and enjoy the breeze. Trade wind symbolizes the freedom of movement, the free will of the free bird to go anywhere it pleases. Unlike the caged bird, who is restricted behind the bars of its cage. Fat worms symbolizes the freedom to choose what it wants to eat by going anywhere it wants, which is denied by the caged bird. The caged bird is restricted and is discriminated and cannot exercise free will even for the most ordinary things. Now the explanation of the fourth stanza. In this stanza, the poet says that free bird thinks of another breeze because he is used to lead a life of ease. Another breeze refers to another opportunity that may help the greedy and lazy free to enjoy life without making any effort. This stanza refers to the unrestricted movement of the free bird, where the free bird thinks of another breeze. The trade wind symbolizes the fact that the free bird can take another flight in the sky and fly against the breeze. Sighing trees refers to the sighing sound made by the breeze while passing through the leafy branches. The poet also mentions that the fat worms that were waiting on the lawn at sunrise to be consumed by him. It indirectly represents that the free bird can also find its own food since they have got freedom. It appears as if the bird had named the sky his own, since there are no other bird to contest with him. Now, the poetic device used in this stanza are, number one, the rhyming scheme. Internal rhyming scheme is used in this stanza, and the lines from the stanza are, and the fat worms waiting on the dawn bright lawn. Number two, alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of the consonant sound at the beginning of the nearby words, and the line from the stanza is, and the fat worms waiting on a dawn bright lawn. Number three, auditory image. It creates a deep auditory effect on the readers. Auditory image is produced when the poet refers to the birds singing and the trees sighing. Number four, personification. The poet has personified when he says that the tree winds soft through the sighing trees, where sighing trees refers to the sighing sound made by the breeze while the passing through the leafy branches. Number five, hyperbole is identified extravagant exaggeration, not to be taken literally but used figuratively to create emphasis, and the lines from the stanza is, and he names the sky his own. Now I move towards the fifth stanza, and the lines are, but a caged bird stands at the graves of dream. His shadow shouts on a nightmare scream. And wings are clipped and the feet are tied. So he opens his throat to sing. Now the word meaning. Dreams refer to the series of images and emotions occurring during sleep. Grave means a place for the burial of a corpse. Nightmare scream means the bird's shadow, that is the Afro-American screams, as if its life were in nightmare. The bird's cries is compared to the nightmare. Throat to sing means, once again, the caged bird sings for freedom. Now the explanation of the fifth stanza. In this stanza, the poet says that the caged bird has no freedom, so all his dreams seems to be unachievable in his life. He has given up all his dreams of liberty and flying freely in the sky. His dreams are now dead. It deals with the ideal form of justice and freedom, along with the reflection over social disparity. She illustrates the nature of captivity and freedom through the stark contest created between them by the brilliant use of birds as a metaphor. She wants to portray how pitiable and worse than any nightmare is the condition of a caged bird. The poet's feelings about her own dreams is now revealed in the line, stands on a grave of dreams. She also has many dreams that had died because she was never given the freedom to achieve all that her white counterparts were able to achieve. Discrimination and racism made up her cage. It is pitiable and adverse, like a nightmare. His wings are clipped and feet are tied. There is only a little hope for freedom. And so the bird opens his throat to sing. The bird wishes to travel against all the adversities. There is a faint but kindling voice of hope in his song. Now the literary device used in this stanza are, number one, the rhyming scheme. There is no definite rhyming scheme followed in this poem. There are few lines which rhyme internally, and the word from the stanza is dreams and scream. Number 2 alliteration. The line is shadow shouts on a nightmare scream is an alliteration where there is a repetition of the consonant sound S. Number 3 personification. The poet has personified, that is applied, human characteristic in the line. His shadow shouts on a nightmare scream, where the shadow refers to the powerless and dead figure. The scream or cry is coming for the shadow instead of the bird, whom no one is paying any attention or any heed. Number 4 metaphor. In this stanza, the caged bird is a metaphor for the poet herself. The caged bird represents the misery and the distress of all those Afro-Americans who had to face inhuman treatment during the apartheid. Number 5 foreshadowing is a literary device in which the poet gives an advance hint of what is to come later in the poem. The poet's use of foreshading is seen in the plight of the caged bird. The fate of the caged bird will be unrelenting miseries, and the death of imprisonment and oppression continued. This inevitable outcome of the despair of the caged bird is seen through the words grave, nightmare, and screams in this stanza. Number 6 is the auditory images. In this stanza, the line, the bird's shadow shouts on a nightmare scream, is an important auditory image imagery. Now I move toward the 6th and the last stanza, and the lines are, the caged bird sings with a fearful trill of things unknown but longed for still, and his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings for freedom. Now the word meaning. Trill means to produce sound in an unsteady way, especially because you are afraid or nervous. Fearful means experiencing or showing fear. Unknown means not known. Longed for refers to desire. Tune means a succession or note forming a distinctive sequence. Distant refers to the separation in space or coming from far away. Freedom means the condition of being free. Now the explanation of the 6th and the last stanza. In this stanza, the poet focuses on the caged bird. Again, as the poet implies that even though the caged bird may have never experienced true freedom, deep down that bird still knows that it was created to be free. Although freedom to the caged bird is fearful because it is unknown, he still longs for freedom. Here the speaker reveals that his cry for freedom is heard on the distant hill. In the last line, the poet says, for the caged bird sings for freedom, implies that although the caged bird may never have experienced freedom, he still sings of it because he was created for freedom. The poet feels that the Black Americans wrote, sang, danced, and cried out for freedom, which was only heard as a distant voice. Yet, this would not stop them from crying out for freedom and equality, because they knew that they were made for freedom and they would not relent until they were given this right as human beings to enjoy the freedom they were created to enjoy. Now the poetic device used in this stanza are, number 1, the rhyming scheme. This stanza follows the rhyming scheme of end rhymes, and the word from the stanza are trill, still, and hill. Number 2, visual imagery. The poet has used vivid imagery in this stanza, and distant hill is an example of visual imagery in this stanza. Auditory imagery. In this stanza, fearful trill is an example of auditory imagery. Number 4, personification. The poet has personified, that is applied, human characteristic of the two birds when he says, sings for freedom. Number 5. Repetition. The poet has repeated few lines in the poem to emphasize the distressed condition of the untrodden people. Now I will tell you the theme of the poem. I know why the cage birds sing. The theme of the poem is number 1. Freedom versus confinement is the most predominant theme of the poem. The poem runs throughout the poem. The freedom is symbolized through the unrestricted movement of the free bird, whereas confinement or enslavement is symbolized of the caged bird, whose wings are clipped and feet are tied. The image of free bird living a life of unparalleled joy and liberty stands for freedom, while enslavement refers to the restricted life of the cage. The free bird leaps and floats freely in the sky that he claims his own, moves freely in the natural habitat untroubled, whereas the caged bird cannot fly freely as it is imprisoned behind the bars of the cage. So it is full of rage and is furious, but helpless and miserable, and longs for freedom and its sad song for a betterment tomorrow, for a better tomorrow. The restricted life of the caged bird stands for the inequality, injustice, and discrimination that the Afro-Americans had to face during that time. In this beautiful poem, the poet describes the painful condition of losing your freedom. Number 2. Voice against injustice. The caged bird did raise its voice against discrimination, even though it was heard at a distant voice. The caged bird is subjected to a constant physical and emotional and mental torture, whose freedom was taken away by force. But even after such a curved, crucial treatment, the caged bird hopes for freedom and refuses to give up. It longs for a day when it would experience its freedom of life. It sings for freedom when in such a miserable state. It is a reference to the condition of the Afro-Americans who wrote songs, sang, and delighted in hope. Freedom and equality. Hope for freedom and equality. Number 3. Racism. In this poem, racism is indirectly drawn to our attention to the racial discrimination that existed in America during the time of apartheid that separated the whites and the Afro-Americans in the society. The caged bird symbolizes the Afro-Americans and the inhuman way in which they were treated just because of the different color of their skin. The caged birds represent the entire Afro-American community that was subjected to social, cultural, and religious discrimination and were denied the right to freedom. Number 4. Influence of childhood. In this poem, we can see how the knowledge and experience gained from childhood affects the rest of the life of the poet. Number 5. Autobiographical account of the poet. In this poem, we can see that the caged bird is a symbol of the poet herself, who had to face a lot of discrimination, harassment, and assault since a very early age. She belonged to the Afro-American community and she was a woman. She felt like a trapped bird who could do nothing but only sing for freedom. In the same way, she refuses to give up and expressed herself through her writings and wrote for freedom and forced the whites to hear and fulfill their demand for freedom. Now the moral of the poem. The moral of the poem is to elaborate the differences between the same species who get different types of situation in life and hence further shows their different stars and dreams. And the free bird dares to claim the sky while the caged birds can only open their throat to sing. It has highlighted the racial discrimination in the late 19th century. It expresses the idea that freedom is a natural state, and knowledge of this fact that cannot be undone by any amount of oppression, imprisonment, or limitation of opportunity. This poem tells us that the power of words, which can bring hope and willingness to preserve to the downtrodden. It also reflects on the importance of acceptance and tolerance in any community. The free bird is soft, indicative of authority, innate rights, and self-ownership, whereas the caged bird is associated with darkness, pain, and fear. Now, dear children, the most important thing which you should keep in mind while preparing for your exam is that every extract which comes in your exam has 5 questions, out of which 4 questions carry 3 marks each, and the last question carries 4 marks, in which they can ask you how appropriate the title of the poem is, in which you have to answer in a big lengthier way than the above 4 questions. You can also be asked about the theme of the poem, poetic devices, and what is the moral of the poem. They can also ask why repetition is used in the poem so many times. It is to emphasize one particular idea. That is why the poet uses repetition. So with these words, I end my lesson. Hope it will be beneficial for you in your studies. Thank you.